Now, let's discuss his graduating class this morning. This morning, there are 350 receiving degrees, 282 undergraduates and 68 graduate students. Among the undergraduate, 27 will receive honors, 23 graduating with Latin honors, and 4 with university honors. The average age of this class is 26.7 years old, and of the 350 graduates this morning, 332 are South Carolinians, 95% of this year's graduating class.
Mr. President, Madam First Lady, Mr. President Pro Tem of the Senate, other elected officials, family members, and most importantly, the only reason we're really here, graduates. It is an incredible honor to join you as a degree holder from Francis Marion, this incredible college. You know, I remember 23 years ago, I think it was 1993, it seemed just like today. I remember it in explicit detail. I remember walking down that aisle. I remember dinner with the family the night before. I remember my wife-to-be being there to watch me get my degree. It was a sunny morning. It was crisp, and the mountain air was coming down into one of our other universities where I graduated from in this state. I even remember the lady in front of me with her blonde hair coming down the black gown and the guy behind me kind of shuffling his feet, as some of these guys did, walking down the aisle. But you know what I'm ashamed to say I don't remember? You know what is highly embarrassing to stand here and realize I cannot recall? I don't remember who the commencement speaker was. In fact, as I've asked around to friends and families about who their commencement speakers were, nobody remembers who their commencement speaker was, except for a couple where the commencement speakers got indicted and put in jail a year or two later. So, I don't want to go that route, but I want you to remember this day. And I want you to remember your commencement speaker. So it's Senator Vincent Shaheen with a V and a S. Keep the programs and take them home. Graduates, you have accomplished so much. Oh, man. And parents and family members, you have worked so hard alongside them. Graduates, you are standing on the shoulders of your family, and you will lift your families up. You will lift them up, not just in this generation, but because of what you've achieved for generations to come. Don't forget where you came from, and don't forget who helped get you there. Don't forget. And we need you, okay? Your state needs you. Your country needs you. Right now, today, in this country, you are the most important people. You are the most important group of people in America at this hour, at this day. I believe that with all my heart. My dad grew up in a family where his parents were not able to go to college. His father, my grandfather, ran a gas station. His mother, my grandmother, stayed at home and helped raise the kids, and they all worked hard, just like you today. And I guess that there are probably many of you who, like my dad, were the first generation to go to college. And he found real joy in a certain place at the end of his career. It was right here in this college at Francis Marion, where he ran the nonprofit institute and rural initiative programs. And we lost my dad this past summer, but it is all the more an honor to stand before you and receive a degree at a place that he really loved. So thank you, graduates and faculty, for allowing me to do that. All right, I'm supposed to give you some advice. All right, that's what a commencement speaker is supposed to do. So you ready? Yeah? All right. You gotta remember the name and the advice, okay? I'm gonna make it simple. Three things. Number one, do not be afraid. That might sound like some strange advice for a graduation, but I see a lot of fear in people these days, more than I have in most of my life. Fear always exists in a society, and mostly it's unreasonable fear, but it's also real. You know, when I was a kid 40 years ago, it was communists and serial killers. That's what everybody was afraid of, communists and serial killers. Now it's all the other boogeymen that you know about. And unfortunately, the boogeyman that our leaders and our media all too often lift up and shove in your face. Some are real and some are not, but I'm here to tell you, graduates, don't be afraid. For remember this, that those who trade in fear and in hate, whether they're politicians who just want your vote, or the media that wants your eyes, or businesses that want your dollars, they feed on your fear. Don't give it to them. Don't be afraid. I know what I'm talking about. I said goodbye last year in the South Carolina Senate one afternoon to my seatmate and my friend. And I woke up in the middle of that night to take a phone call that he had been killed along with eight other people who were massacred in his church. My seatmate, my friend, the Reverend Clementa Pinckney, he was not afraid. He was a fearless person. And when in that previous year I had called for the Confederate flag to be retired from the State House grounds, I got the hate email, okay? I got the threats, I got the denigrations, but I knew that I had nothing to fear. Nothing to fear but being afraid. How do you conquer hate with love? How do you conquer fear with courage? So don't be afraid. And let me share this with you. We live in the most glorious time in the history of humanity. Right now, right here, the words of Franklin Roosevelt ring out to me today. We have nothing to fear but fear itself, nameless, unreasoning, unjustified terror. So face down the fears with the facts. I'll leave just a few with you. Fact, right now we live in one of the safest, least violent periods of human history. Fact, in America, our crime rate is one of the lowest it has ever been since it's been recorded. That's right, it's lower than when I was a kid in the 70s, lower than the 60s, lower than the 80s. So when you have kids, let them go out and play in the park, okay? Here's a fact. You are hundreds of times more likely to be killed by a lightning strike in America than in a terrorist attack. Don't you be afraid to go outside. Right now in America, we don't have any civil war. We don't have any depression. We don't have any terrible diseases raging across our continent. Don't be afraid to do whatever you want. Advice number two, be a joiner. Join a club or a church or anything that gets you around other people. There was a Frenchman that came to this country and studied us from afar. His name was de Tocqueville. He came shortly after the Revolutionary War, and what impressed him most was what he called a unique attraction of Americans to join together in associations. We join together, we're joiners. And he said, Americans of all ages, all conditions, all minds, they constantly unite. And not only do they have commercial associations they take part in, they have thousands of other kind. Religious, moral, grave, feudal, very general, very particular, immense and small. They join together to give parties, to raise inns, to have churches. That was America then. But let me share this with you. This country has been changing over the last three decades. In America now, less than one-third of our citizens belong to any voluntary associations. And these are the associations that really can and will enrich your lives. So you have a choice, graduates. Retreat back into what is an increasingly solitary community, into a self-absorbed small life, or engage in your society, build those relationships, go outside your workplace, go outside your home, and join a civic organization. When you have kids, join the PTA, be a leader, grab your friend, and if you don't want to do any of that, just get a group together and go out to drink or play cards or do whatever once a month, okay? You're already doing that, some of you. I can tell. be with people, be joiners. Man and woman is a social animal. So join. And not only will you enrich your lives, but you will enrich our society. Advice number three, take risks. If you don't take a risk, you will never, ever succeed. Failing in a goal is nothing to be ashamed of. The only thing you should ever be ashamed of is if you don't try in the first place. In fact, if you try and come up short, that's not a failure. That's just trying and coming up short. I know. I have won and I have lost in many things in life. In business, in court cases, in politics. In life, what matters is, what did you make a difference? Look, I ran for the South Carolina Senate 4 times and I won every time. I ran for governor 2x, and you know they're calling me senator today, right? Once it was extremely close, and once not so much. And my opponent in the governor's race got the mansion and the free car and all the food and the big office. But the issues that I pushed, the issues that my opponent opposed, those are the positions that were victorious, that now are successful. Expanding 4-year-old kindergarten across South Carolina, retiring the Confederate flag from the State House grounds, putting money into road construction. Those are victories that will change the lives of you and people in this state forever. The victories that affect other people, those are the victories worth winning. So try and never quit trying, push and never quit pushing, and then rest and catch your breath and try again. Let me wrap this up with just a little story. And then I can't wait to see you get your degrees. This is a story about a river. There are only 2 kinds of fish that live in this river. One fish, it goes whatever way the river sweeps it. And one day she may be swept into a wonderful bend in the stream with plenty of food and an easy life. And the next day she might end up in a muddy hole because she lives her life day to day focused on herself. She hopes for the best, but she takes life as it comes. And in the end, this fish might end up in a flooded pond full of food and easy living. And you see those fish out there. Or she may be swept into the ocean and become bait for the bigger fish. The point here is that for good or for ill, her fate is going to be decided by the way the river flows. But remember, there's another fish in this river. This fish is the fighter, the swimmer, the jumper, the liver. And she sets out every day with a plan and with a mission to move upstream or downstream, whatever she chooses that day. And she searches for food and she swims away from the danger and she heads upstream when it's time to lay her eggs. And for good or for ill, and she doesn't know what it will be, she chooses her own destiny. And the river of life, it holds many more passive fish who flow with the current than the fish who actually choose their own way. Because if you believe that the currents are going to decide your fate, then you'll never truly succeed. And you'll accept whichever way the river pushes you. But if you believe in your heart, if you believe in your soul, if you believe in every fiber of your being that you're the master of your own inner destiny, then, and only then, can you change this world. And you will. Thank you.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees and the faculty for Francis Marion University, I confer upon you your respective degrees with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
At this time, we present the candidates for the undergraduate degrees. I wish to ask Mr. Kenneth W. Jackson, Chair of the Board of Trustees for Francis Marion University, to assist in the presentation of the diplomas for the undergraduate degrees. Will the graduates please come forward to receive your diplomas? College of Liberal Arts, Bachelor of General Studies. Braylon Shamare Blouse. Sierra Renna Fishburn. Marcy Brianna Franklin. Sydney Bryn Gandy. Octavius Delquan Harrington. Shaniqua Patrice Ingram. Sydney Marsh Perry. Tashima Aisha Presley. Summer Santana Roush. April Shaniqua Robinson. Sloane Elizabeth Shank. Samisha Gabrielle Short. Danette Marshall Smith. Nikesha Unique Smith. Hannah Lauren Townsend. Bachelor of Science.
The peace that passes all understanding, the love that looks beyond all of our faults, and the grace that is able to sustain us be upon you all now and evermore. Amen.
Fly with the stars in the skies. I am no longer trying to survive. I believe that life is a prize, but to live doesn't mean you're alive. Don't worry about me and who I fire. I get what I desire, it's my empire. And yes, I call the shots, I am the umpire. I sprinkle holy water upon the vampire. In this very moment, I'm king. In this very moment, I slay Goliath with a sling. This very moment, I bring, put it on everything. That I will retire with the ring, and I will retire with the crown. Yes, no, I'm not lucky, I'm blessed. Yes, clap for the heavyweight champ, me. But I couldn't do it all alone. We, Young Money raised me, grew up out in Paisley, Southside Jamaica, Queens, and it's crazy. Cause I'm still hood, Hollywood couldn't change me. Shout out to my haters, sorry that you couldn't faze me. Ain't being cocky, we just vindicated. Best believe that when we done, this moment will be syndicated. I don't know, this night just remind me of everything they deprived me of. Put your drinks up, it's a celebration every time we link up. We done did everything they could think of. Greatness is what we wanna bring up.
I wish that I could have this moment for life. For life. For life. Cause in this moment I just feel so alive. 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 I wish that I
drop down to your knees. Young Money, the mafia, that's where the love sees. I'm in the Dominican, Big Poppy Ortiz, doing target practice, all these groupies just aiming to please. Shout out to the CEO, 500 degrees. Shout out to the OVO, Red Wings and Fatigues. Ah, so didn't wanna be friends, how coincidental? This supposed to be our year, we ain't get the memo. A young king, pay me a gold. 40 got a bunch of weed, he ain't even roll. These niggas be dropping songs, they ain't even cold. Weezy on top of that, they ain't even home yet. Yeah, be very afraid. These other rappers getting bodied and carried away.
Look at me and Nicki Nick getting married today. And now you bitches that be hating can catch a bouquet. Ooh, yeah, you a star in my eyes. You and all them white girls, party of five. Are we drinking a little more? I can hardly decide. I can't believe we really made it. I'm partly surprised. I swear, damn, this one for the books, man. I swear this shit is as fun as it looks, man. I'm really trying to make it more than what it is. Cause everybody dies, but not everybody lives.
That I could have this moment for life. For life. For life. Cause in this moment I just feel so alive. 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 I wish that I could have this moment for life. For life. For life. This is my moment. I just feel so sunsets, I have become alive. I wish that I could have this moment for life. For life. For life. Cause in this moment I just feel so alive. 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 I wish that I could have this moment for life. My moment, I just feel so alive.
Mexicano, I'm working like a Mexicano. New persona, I'm moving off of Ferragamo. Get the llama, I party with the real Madonna. Beat the odds, do numbers, and remain humble. Drop tie punches, I'm so used to this. Smoking at the pound, I'm so used to this. I know where I'm from, but I got used to this. Mansion in the hills, I got used to this. Take a booty, bitches, I got used to this. This ice flood in my wrist, I done got used to this. Type of kind of bitches, I got all kind of flags. Selling dope all my life, I can't do minimum wage. Daddy, daddy, money, I got used to this. I give you my whole heart till it ain't nothing to give. You know how far we came if you know where we been. How many niggas you know can happen to biz? Be honest to yourself, don't you never pretend. Don't ever play yourself, know when it all begins. I had put my back against the wall.
And what?
Tell me that I don't deserve a ball. Mexicano, I'm working like a Mexicano. New persona, I'm moving off of Ferragamo. Get the llama, I party with the real Madonna. Beat the odds, do numbers, and remain humble. Drop tie punches, I'm so used to this. Smoking at the pound, I'm so used to this. I know where I'm from, but I got used to this. Mansion in the hills, I got used to this.
Lambo come alive, man, I'm used to this. No one looks surprised, cause we used to this. I'ma make sure that we get used to this. Treat my brother's kids like they one of my kids. Never looking back on it, we did what we did. Could never find the time for the people I miss. Thought they had my back against the wall. Tell me that I don't deserve a ball.
Well then tell me who deserve it. Eyes get low, but I'm still observing. I see you lurking. Never see me out in person. I'm always...
Thank you.